Channel 46 News at 10 is next. Neighbors fear the spread of meningitis as police investigate the deaths of three infants.
Georgians respond to a critical blood shortage, but thousands of pints are still needed. And Atlanta honors the birthday of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.
Steve Taylor is here to highlight the Tech Louisville game.
And Terry Neese says, hey, some sunshine's on the way.
All that and next on Georgia's News at 10.
From Channel 46 in Atlanta, this is Georgia's News at 10.
Good evening. I'm Kevin Coakley.
And I'm Gwen Scott, and this is Georgia's News at 10.
It's a new service, but its purpose is time-honored. It is the news, and here it is.
Tonight, Forest Park police refused to rule out foul play in the deaths of three quadruplets infected with meningitis.
News at 10's John McKnight is at Clayton General Hospital right now, where that fourth infant is being watched for signs of that same disease. John?
Well, Kevin and Gwen, officials here at Clayton General Hospital told me just a few minutes ago that 3-month-old DeAndre Walker is in good condition tonight and is doing very well. We should know by tomorrow morning the results of tests conducted over the past 48 hours, and those tests should tell us whether DeAndre Walker has meningitis, the disease suspected in the deaths of the other Walker infants. Meanwhile, News at 10 reporter Betty Bailey was out talking to the Walkers' neighbors today, and some of them say they're worried the disease will spread.
Everybody wants to know why. Why 3 out of 4 quadruplets died Friday in this house on Glen Drive.
So many people, you know, asking me, did I know where the street was? I told them no, but I guess I could find it.
The babies were 3 months old. Autopsies show each one had meningitis. While the cause of death isn't certain, a deadly form of the disease can kill in just 24 hours. Here in the pediatrics ward of Clayton General Hospital, the surviving child, DeAndre Walker, is under constant watch.
At this point, the tests are being run that the physician has ordered, and the baby's here for observation.
Okay, but no problems?
No problems right now.
Medical officials aren't releasing many details, and people in this Forest Park neighborhood are concerned. One family living across the street says it's going to be tested for meningitis just to be safe.
It's knowing that it's contagious, that anybody could catch it, no matter who you are. That's the main concern to me, especially with the kids that I have here.
I'm scared that I'll catch what they got, what they had.
Medical experts say the neighbors don't have much cause for concern, since it takes a lot of exposure to catch meningitis. But the Lathans, at least, say they won't take any chances when dealing with a killer that can strike overnight. Betty Bailey, Channel 46, News at 10.
Clayton General Hospital officials have another problem to worry about tonight, and it's a worry that's shared by hospitals throughout Georgia. The Red Cross in Atlanta is facing a critical blood shortage. The inventory of blood is 3,000 pints low. Over the past week, more than 50 people with scheduled elective surgery have had that surgery postponed. Fortunately, this weekend, a lot of people are rolling up their sleeves to help.
The dreaded needle. First-time donor Mary Frances Shepherd, a little sting.
She's still
smart. It wasn't so bad. Well, Mary Frances is only one of thousands that responded to the emergency appeal. The critical shortage of blood has even prompted the Red Cross to keep its Monroe Drive Donor Center open through the weekend. The Red Cross says the response has been encouraging, but the crisis isn't over yet. As of last Thursday, the blood bank was about 4,500 pints low. Since then, the emergency appeal has brought in about 1,200 pints above normal daily needs, but that still leaves the blood inventory more than 3,000 pints short. Also, there's a special need for O-positive and B-positive blood types. Doug Redeer of the Red Cross says it's been a real challenge to keep hospitals supplied with blood.
We found it necessary in some cases to transfer blood from one hospital to another to meet emergency needs. And that's not a desirable situation. It's much better if hospitals have sufficient blood in their blood banks when an emergency occurs.
But the crisis has been eased a bit thanks to people like 23-year-old Michelle Burns. She finds the courage to face the needle with a helping hand from a friend. No, Michelle is no rookie. She's donated blood 10 times. She's a medical student at Emory, but it still stings a little bit.
I don't particularly like it, but when I'm through, I know.
Red Cross Donor Center will be open longer hours tomorrow. The Red Cross hopes that people who are off work for the King holiday will take the opportunity to come in and donate blood. There will also be special blood drives. If you'd like any more information, you can call the Red Cross 24 hours at 881-9800. 24-hour Red Cross number. Kevin and Gwen?
Okay, let's hope plenty of people pick up that phone. Thanks,
you
John.
Bet.
Thank you, John. Well, at least 100 people are dead from a train collision in Bangladesh, and human error is a possible cause. A railway executive says operations may not have known how to properly work a new flagging system. A Bangladesh government commission will investigate whether crossed signals caused the head-on collision of two trains. About 1,000 people are hospitalized, but the death toll could climb tomorrow as crews remove more bodies trapped in that wreckage. Tonight, the Pentagon tells news at 10 it knows nothing about a report that an American soldier may be responsible for the bombing of Pan Am Flight 103. An English newspaper reports that a serviceman may have unknowingly brought the bomb on board, thinking that it was a smuggled package of diamonds. Flight 103 was bound for New York when it exploded over Scotland last month, killing all 259 people aboard and 11 more on the ground.
More than half a dozen nuclear protesters are in the jail tonight. That's after they were arrested at Kings Bay Naval Base. They were protesting the arrival of the USS Tennessee. That's the first Trident nuclear submarine to be homeported at Kings Bay. Eventually, there will be 10 subs at that base. It's the site of a welcoming ceremony this afternoon. Each Trident sub carries 24 nuclear missiles, and the 8 protesters who were arrested and the 100 others who weren't say those nuclear subs simply don't belong in Kings Bay. Now, Congressman Ben Jones, who now represents the 4th District, is here, joins us now on News at 10. Congressman, do you have any problems with those subs being based at Kings Bay, or do you share the sentiments of Senator Sam Nunn, who says they are both a great asset for Georgia and an instrument of peace around the world?
I agree with Senator Nunn. I think the Tridents are an important part of our nuclear triad and our deterrent in that sense. We all long for the day when we don't need them, but right now we do. By the way, I want to say what a pleasure it is for me to be here on your maiden voyage.
Thank you.
I hope the 10 o'clock news idea is a great one, of course. It's done throughout the country, and maybe it's like General Nathan Bedford Forrest said, you got there firstest with the mostest.
Well, thank you, Congressman. I have a quick question for you. We're sort of running short of time, but I wanted to know, you got 2 assignments recently that pleased you. Could you just speak to that a little bit?
We got the committee assignments we wanted. Our major committee is going to be Public Works and Transportation, and our non-major committee was also our first choice, which is Veterans Affairs. And my feeling was that these were the committees which would have the most immediate and direct impact on our constituency here in the 4th District. Of course, Atlanta's a transportation center. We've got rapid rail, and we've got airports, and we've got interstate highways, all those things that Public Works and Transportation deals with. And also, we have over 70,000 veterans in this district, and of course the VA hospital here in Decatur.
Well, you've got your work cut out for you, that's for sure.
And thanks for joining us tonight, and hope to see you later this week at the inauguration.
I'll be there.
Okay, thanks, Congressman.
Thank you.
And in other political news, tonight George Bush is working on his inaugural address. The president-elect is back in Washington after a fishing weekend in Florida. The speech is taking top priority with Bush. It'll mark his first public appearance as president of the United States. Aides say Bush wants to use the speech to define a direction for America's future.
And as Georgia's News at 10 continues tonight, Atlantans play tribute to Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. on what would have been his 60th birthday.
And we're going to take you to the King Center, where some say Dr. King's dream is put into action.
Plus, our signature story deals with a tough subject to talk about, child abusers, a profile of those who victimize children.
Monday only, one day super Chevy sale at your heart of Georgia Chevy dealers. Monday, January 16th, every Chevrolet car, truck, and van will be marked with special one-day pricing. Without question, your best opportunity to buy a new Chevrolet car, truck, or van this year. One-day discounts in effect for 12 hours only. This one-day super Chevy sale absolutely ends Monday. So bring your title or payment book. All factory cash incentives will apply during this one-day super Chevy sale. Hurry for this once-in-a-lifetime opportunity at the heart of Georgia Chevy dealer in your hometown.
It's important to the Applebee's to save money whenever they can. Because they shop at Walmart, they really do get the low, everyday price on everything they need, day in and day out. Because they shop at Walmart, they don't have to run around all over town looking for sales. And because they shop at Walmart, they were able to save enough money for a nanny. Walmart, the everyday low price on the brands you trust every day.
They say drink plenty of fluids. What do they know? Swallowing's total pain.
When your throat hurts, Chloraseptic works on contact. Because only Chloraseptic has the power of phenol to penetrate nerve endings and stop sore throat pain fast.
Well, here's looking at you.
Chloraseptic is fast relief.
Is a mud clean really worth it? Mud mask or new mud scrubbing mask. For a deep clean or a smooth polished clean, nothing feels cleaner than mud.
My period isn't the problem. It's the period before my period. So, I take Premsen PMS to relieve bloating, pain, irritability, moodiness. So I'm my old, sweet self again. Premsen PMS for the period before your period.
Right now at the Atlanta Civic Center, hundreds of music lovers are raising their voices in song. That in tribute to Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. This caps off another day of activities highlighting the fourth national holiday to honor Dr. King's birthday. News at 10 reporter Denise Agent has more on the day's festivities.
Church services were just part of the celebration. It was a full day. 17 runners made the annual run from Selma, Alabama to Atlanta. The goal is to run the relay until the total miles equal a trip around the world. Inside Ebenezer Baptist Church, hundreds gathered to remember the dreamer nearly 21 years after his death.
We resolve that this holiday must forever stand as a testament to the American dream, for which he gave his life.
In her State of the Dream address, Mrs. Coretta Scott King challenged us to create a world where nations are united by a common bond of love and goodwill.
Instead of the arms race, we want to lift up the human race.
Mrs. Coretta Scott King acknowledges that the dream has not yet been fulfilled, but the work is not confined to Atlanta. The goal is to train millions in the nation and around the world in nonviolent social change. That, Mrs. King says, is the key to ridding the world of corrosive cancers like poverty, racism, and violence. Then, Mrs. King says, the dream will be fulfilled. Denise Agin, Channel 46, News at 10.
King Week festivities are just a small part of the work of the King Center. News at 10's Lee Green reports on the center's year-round mission.
For many Atlantans and visitors to Atlanta, the King Center is essentially a shrine, the final resting place of a man whose impact in life rivaled that of Mahatma Gandhi. The center estimates that over 1 million people visited there last year, making it Georgia's third largest tourist attraction. Visitors to the center find a museum of Dr. King's life and the civil rights struggle he led. But the center is much more than a tribute to the past.
What we do offer is nonviolent training programs for a broad range of individuals. Our annual summer workshop on nonviolence brings in young people and adults from all over the country and, quite frankly, from around the world who want to learn more about Dr. King and how to apply his philosophies and strategies in today's world.
The center survives largely on donations, both personal and corporate. But without the volunteer work of the King family, the center couldn't manage. Dr. King's widow, Coretta Scott King, announced yesterday she will be turning over the center's presidency to her son, Dexter, in April. But Mrs. King will remain as spokeswoman and chief executive officer. No member of the family receives payment from the center.
So it's amazing just what it does in uplifting people to say, I can do something. There's something I can do.
The real work of the center takes place in workshops where the philosophy of nonviolent change is taught.
If we join together in peace and harmony.
This seminar is being conducted by Dr. King's daughter, Bernice. The center's recently announced goal is to train 100,000 leaders from around the world, who in turn will train a nonviolent army of 10 million to bring about what Dr. King called the beloved community. Graduates of the Kingian philosophy include Atlanta Mayor Andrew Young.
One of the reasons why I think we have so little violence is that we aggressively use the tactics and techniques of nonviolence even in our police force.
More recent workshop graduates confirm their lives
have been changed.
As a military unit, we are for peace. We try to keep peace. And to know nonviolent ways to keep that peace, it's better to our advantage.
Taught me that, you know, you should learn to love the ones that, you know, treat you wrong.
I believe this can, I can use this to apply in classes and my personal relationships.
Around here, they like to tell the story of the St. Louis police lieutenant who came to the center in 1981. As a result of his training, he refused to wear a gun when he got back, although working in a high-risk area. Today, the lieutenant is a captain, and many other members of the force have adopted his nonviolent methodology for conflict resolution. Dr. King's dream is alive, and nowhere more so than here at the King Center. Lee Green, Channel 46, News at 10.
And just ahead tonight on Georgia's News at 10. It looks as if Americans are beginning to win the battle against heart disease.
I would like to believe that the evening's beautiful sunset was the result of the premiere of Georgia's News at 10. I do know that we'll have more sunsets ahead this week to look forward to.
I got the call in the middle of the night. My father was in intensive care. I had to be on the next plane to Chicago. I needed more credit on my Citibank Visa.
He immediately called the Citibank 800 number. He told me he needed emergency credit, and he told me why.
She got $600 approved at 3 in the morning. Citibank was there when I needed them, so I could be there when my father needed me.
Not just Visa, Citibank Visa.
Today, you can get $1,000 cash back on selected new Suzuki Sidekicks, up to $700 cash back on a new 16-valve Swift. With Suzuki to dealer incentives, you can save even more on four-wheel drive Sidekicks and on 16-valve Swifts. It's the great savings countdown, only at your Suzuki dealer, only on Sidekicks and Swifts. Up to $1,000 cash back, but only for a limited time. See your Suzuki dealer today.
Do you see this bag? It can change your life. It changed me, Vicki Lawrence, into a gourmet cook. This is New Minute Gourmet. And this microwave cooking bag blends the flavors of the Minute Gourmet sauces with your fresh meats. You can make sensational chicken cacciatore, oriental beef, and more. Mmm, it's a real taste breakthrough. If you thought packaged meals had to taste ordinary, New Minute Gourmet will really change your mind. Might even change your life.
New Hunt's Minute Gourmet. The other guys do a pretty good chicken impression, but in fact, their chicken is often chopped, pressed, even rearranged. At Hardee's, our chicken is real chicken. Our chicken sandwich starts with whole chicken breast. That's because we never forget, you can always go someplace else. So come into Hardee's while the other guys try to figure out just what real chicken is.
Hello, doggy.
Now get a chicken sandwich and regular fries for only $2.19 at Hardee's.
There is encouraging news tonight in the fight against heart disease. A new American Heart Association study shows that the number of deaths has dropped dramatically over the past 10 years by 24%. The doctors credit exercise and better health care for that decline.
We have some other good news, weather news, but Terry Neese says not so fast because tomorrow morning rush hour might be a little shaky.
A little dicey.
We will have some fog in the morning to contend with, but after the fog clears out, we are in store for some sunshine. You'll want to keep that in mind. The fog, you might want to add a little extra time to your driving tomorrow morning. Let's check the current conditions as we take a trip over to Peachtree this evening. Right now, we do have cloudy skies. The temperature, 46 degrees. Wind from the northwest at 7 miles an hour. The relative humidity is 89%. Barometric pressure steady at 30.13. And from midnight last night to the current time at the airport, 2/100ths of an inch of rain. Our high and low temperature combined today left us 6 1/2 degrees above where we should be for this time of year, thanks to that high of 59 and that morning low of 37. Going to introduce you now to our radar. Nothing showing right now on our radar, but earlier this afternoon, 2:15 to be exact, down in the southeast, some patches of rain. They have since cleared out. This is ground clutter around Athens and also up around Dahlonega. We'll be showing you some radar in motion a little bit later on. Adding now to our cloud cover over the southeast, we're going to put this in motion for you. And the clouds continue to move to the northeast, pressing out into the Atlantic. The reason? Well, a stationary front, a cold front behind it. But this ridge of high pressure is slamming in, forcing that out into the Atlantic, and it will take the cloud cover with it. The national satellite picture, along with some radar in the national picture, shows that most of the rain this evening confined over in throughout the southeast. A lot of cloud cover, though, socking in much of the eastern seaboard. Out to the west, we do have a little bit of snow in the mountains of Washington and Oregon. They do have some snow advisories out tonight. And an elongated area of low pressure continues to make its way very slowly into the Rockies. Cold air tonight up in North Dakota. They're looking for some record lows in throughout the Dakotas tonight. Around the nation tomorrow, some rain along the west coast, snow in through the northern Rockies, cloud cover over in through parts of Montana, snow around the western edge of the Great Lakes, and as for our area, bringing it closer to home, sunshine tomorrow with a ridge of high pressure, the rain pushing down into Florida. Let's take a look now at our WGNX forecast for tonight. We will have a little bit of cloud cover throughout the evening, plenty of dense fog in the morning, patchy and widely scattered, winds from the west 5 to 10 miles an hour, and our low temperature tonight in the upper 30s. For tomorrow, late in the day, plenty of sunshine, a northwest wind of around 10 miles an hour, and the high in the upper 50s. The extended forecast, here's what you can look for the next 5 days. Check it out. Plenty of sunshine, temperatures above normal on the highs. We will be in the upper 50s to low 60s, and even on the low category, we'll be above normal.
Well, aside from the fog tomorrow morning, you bring good news. We were looking at rain just a couple days ago.
It's nice to see the sun for a change.
Yeah. Thanks, Terry.
Sure enough.
And thank you. Coming up next on News at 10, our signature story profiles the abuse of children and ways that you can keep your children safe.
Hi.
Henry Block talks with concerned taxpayers.
After the sweeping tax changes we've had the last couple of years, everybody's asking questions. They really don't understand what all the changes mean to them.
Hey, we weren't aware of these returns that we had coming to us. We didn't know.
They were very informative, very relaxed. They explained every step.
I wouldn't switch for nobody.
Join us at H&R Block and get the maximum refund you're entitled to.
I think it's great. Well, and now keep on coming.
Monday, noon till 9, time is money you could be saving during Haverty's 9-hour furniture sale. As Haverty's puts their entire inventory on sale with no payments till May, you'll save on tasteful classic dining rooms, high-quality bedrooms at very low prices, a variety of living rooms from traditional to contemporary, and you make no payments till May. Time is money, but your time to save is Monday only, 12 till 9. So hurry to Haverty's 9-hour furniture sale, where everything's on sale.
American Express has now made applying for the card as easy as picking up the phone.
Hi, American Express. Yes, I'd like to apply for the card.
Hi, American Express. Can I apply for the card right over the phone? Great.
For those who qualify, the card comes with a world of privileges.
American Express, I seem to have lost my wallet with all my cards.
The privilege of having someone on call to help you.
I can have a new card for you by tomorrow.
24 hours a day.
That would be great.
Privileges that extend the free repair period offered under most manufacturers' warranties. Privileges that give you an extra measure of financial flexibility.
I'm glad we stayed an extra day.
I'm glad we have the American Express card.
Just call 1-800 the card.
Take my application for membership.
We'll take your application over the phone and start processing it right away.
American Express. I'd like to apply for membership.
Membership has its privileges. So call 1-800 the card now.
Our signature story tonight is a difficult one to tell. No one wants to talk about child abuse, but then that's part of the problem. And if we don't talk about it, we have no hope of understanding and eliminating it.
Police say Daniel Anthony Fusco was well-liked. He was church-going. He loved movies. He got along well with children, inviting him to play games on his computer and listen to his guitar playing. At his trial, a psychologist described Fusco as bright and normal. These pictures come from a videotape Fusco made, a videotape that includes shots of Fusco having sex with children. Fusco is now serving 160 years in prison. But why didn't someone realize sooner? Dr. Jean Abel has been studying and treating child molesters for 21 years.
Oh, I don't think there's any way in the world you could pick them out in a crowd. All of the sexual deviations, or what we call paraphilias, are unique in that generally the rest of the individual's personality and behavior is very appropriate.
Sergeant Shirley Britton with the Atlanta Police Department Sex Crime Unit says that child molesters come from every segment of society.
We've had people from every economic background that you can imagine, professions, from teachers to doctors, to just a lowlife on the street or something. I mean, anyone can be a child molester.
Here's the case of Lilburn building contractor Ed Dickey. He lived in an upper-middle-class home in Gwinnett County. He considers himself a devout Mormon. In November, he was convicted of sexually abusing two of his daughters over a 9-year period. Throughout the trial, Peggy Dickey stood loyally by her husband, even as her daughters testified against him. The very nature of that case brings home the fact that child molestation can be hidden.
Many times, children who are sexually abused become child molesters themselves. Dr. Abel says that's one reason that an adult will sexually and physically abuse a child.
Being molested is one of the factors. Observing others molesting, that's another factor. Being in a culture in which violence is reinforced.
According to an FBI study, there are two basic types: those who violently attack children and those who coax a child into sex.
The nonviolent child molester often claims more victims, and he may justify the molestation to himself by saying he's not really hurting the child.
This is just sex education. The child really wanted me to be involved with her or him, otherwise they would have reported it long ago. I can tell when a child is being harmed.
Not all child molesters are male. A recent study at the University of Michigan showed as many as 15% of child molesters in the U.S. are women. The National Center for Missing and Exploited Children says that female child molesters are harder to identify. After hearing all of this, how do you protect your child?
If the person seems to be too good to be true in terms of their wanting to help you with your child, they probably are too good to be true. If they spend a lot of time, especially isolated with or want to with a child, that's a tip-off.
And finally, listen to your child. Dr. Abel and other experts agree that children rarely lie about molestation. It's difficult for them to lie about something they've never experienced.
Well, good advice. Up next on News at 10, our parting shot segment takes you to a place in Georgia where the beauty of summer lives on this winter.
And Steve Taylor's here to tell us bad woes at Georgia Tech.
They had their chance to impress some AP voters today. Highlights of their game with Louisville coming up.
Food manufacturers often lower their price for a month or so to get supermarkets to buy more, kind of like a sale. Now, Cub Foods uses these lower costs to lower prices. These green stickers mean Cub is passing the savings right back to you. That's Cub pricing.
Cub Foods, it's a new way to run a supermarket.
It's like having thousands and thousands of sales all around the Cub store.
Watch real close now, take a lesson. Lax goes past, it's like a blessing. Even Lax won't treat you wrong, cause when it's Lax, it's gone. Fact is, Lax is country good. Use fresh lean meat just like you would. Nothing in Lax don't belong, so when it's Lax, it's gone. The Lax boys put in a lot of time making family favorite cold cuts, but they don't put in fillers, just more real meaty taste. One more time, when it's Lax, it's gone.
Time. It's what everybody wants and nobody has enough of. But there is one place where you can pick up a little extra time. Eckerd.
That's the reason there's Eckerd. Because America can't wait.
Save on Love's diapers during Eckerd's Dollar Days. Now just $10. Love's blue for boys and pink for girls puts extra absorbency where it's needed most. Plus mix and match these household supplies. Any two for $3 during Dollar Days at Eckerd.
To many car makers, automotive intelligence is something you get from other car makers. Now they're curious about the newest Saab 9000, a roomy, luxurious performance sedan. Introducing the Saab 9000 CD. It gives new meaning to the term automotive intelligence.
Test drive a new Saab 9000 CD at your local Saab dealers today.
You know, the Georgia teams and the weather have a lot in common this weekend. Lousy on both ends, apparently.
Bulldogs lost at the buzzer yesterday. The Hawks got clobbered. Were there any junior high teams that won this weekend?
Well, look.
Maybe we should focus on them. Chances are Georgia Tech will be nowhere in sight when the top 20 ratings come out tomorrow. Yellow Jackets were 19th heading into the weekend. They lost at North Carolina State Saturday, but had a chance to redeem themselves today at home against 9th-rated Louisville. News at 10's George Bryant was there. He has the highlights.
It was back and forth. The lead changed hands 18 times. Then, with under 2 minutes to play, Kenny Payne hits a three-point basket from the top of the key, giving Louisville the lead for good. But Georgia Tech had a chance to send the game into overtime.
With 14 seconds left to play, Tech was down by a basket. Tech guard Brian Oliver was fouled.
But Oliver missed one of two free throws. In the locker room, he said the shot didn't feel right. He had another chance at the buzzer, but his 40-foot shot did not drop.
We've got to learn to play a little bit smarter, but as far as guts go, I have no complaints. We really gave a tremendous effort. The crowd was great.
I mean, I don't think Coach Crimmins will feel his team played poorly. I think we just happened to be ahead when the time ran out.
It was the Yellow Jackets' second loss in as many days. However, Tech players are not blaming fatigue.
It's one game. One game doesn't make a season. And we just got to go back, watch the film, and really look at the things that we really didn't do well, and go from there.
The final score, the Louisville Cardinals 67, Tech 65. George Bryant, Channel 46, News at 10.
Thank you, George. 8th Rated of North Carolina is wondering about the license plate of the truck that hit them today. Here was the driver of that truck, Richard Morgan, foreman of the Tar Heels to the tune of 39 points. And this was the kind of day it was for Carolina. Long pass, the easy layup. Guess it wasn't that easy. Cavaliers ripped North Carolina today, the final 106-83. Who would have guessed that? The other upset special of the day, Pittsburgh jolting Oklahoma. That ended an 11-game winning streak for the Sooners. Also this afternoon, Florida State knocked off the Southeastern Conference leaders, only the second loss of the season for Tennessee. The Hawks have a rare Monday afternoon game tomorrow at Washington, tip-off on Channel 46, 1 o'clock. Victories have been kind of rare for the Hawks lately. They have lost three in a row. And I'm sure CBS envisioned a classic matchup between Michael Jordan and Larry Bird. Today, when they scheduled the Bulls and the Celtics last fall, it was more like a Reggie Lewis-Michael Jordan confrontation, and you know who's going to win that one. Jordan, 42 points, 11 assists, and 9 steals on the Bulls' 110-104 win today. He really is the Boston Strangler as he moves in there. Courtesy video here of WGNX-TV, and we thank them for that. Celtic coach Jimmy Rogers looking down the bench saying, is Larry back yet? Not yet, maybe a couple of more months. Elsewhere in the NBA, Philadelphia won at Charlotte. Milwaukee made it 6 in a row by beating the Pistons today. Tonight, Indiana is leading Miami 82-75. That is in the fourth quarter. And the Lakers won, finally, after losing 8 in a row on the road. 1 week away from Super Bowl 23 today, Bengal quarterback Boomer Esiason said he's tired of football and may skip the Pro Bowl. Pro golf winners today, Steve Jones winning the Bob Hope Desert Classic. Betsy King, a runaway winner in the Jamaica LPGA tournament. Finally, what has to qualify as the worst play of the week in organized sports happened a couple of nights ago in a Kentucky high school basketball game. Could not have been a more dramatic setting. Central Louisville in the light uniforms led South Louisville by 1 point, 9 seconds left, and watch what happened. One of the Central players got a little disoriented when put the ball in the wrong hoop, but it took him a while to realize it, but he made the winning hoop for the wrong team. How embarrassing. Look for a hole to crawl in there. The poor guy.
Just feel awful.
There goes the scholarship.
Oh, well.
We're going to look ahead now to the news you will want to know about tomorrow. Jesse Jackson hosts the official Martin Luther King holiday in Atlanta.
And the battle over the gas tax heats up at the state capitol as lawmakers hash out Georgia's budget.
And I'll have a special report on what legislators are doing to help cut your insurance bills. All that and more tomorrow night on Channel 46 News at 10.
And after all the tough news of the day, we thought it was only fair to leave you with some food for the soul. We call it parting shots.
It was really Gwen's idea. Tonight, the photographer Kurt Beavis takes us to Callaway Gardens. And there he discovers the quiet strength and grace of some of nature's living paintings. Bert Beavis, one of our many, many very good photographers.
And good friends, too.
This has been a first, and we're glad that you were here to join and share it with us. A new service with much more to follow. I'm Kevin Coakley.
And I'm Gwen Scott. Now from Tribune in New York, here's Marvin Scott and USA Tonight.
Head-on train collision in Bangladesh. Remembering the man and the...